Yes. When you wake up and you feel like you need a little up, when you're down and out and you need to get a little higher, if you feel like you need a blessing and you feel a little high today, welcome to the church of Cali High.
Welcome to Cali High, episode 44, Peter's Garden, Harvest Time. This week, we revisit Peter's grow for a pre-harvest inspection of his amazing colas. Peter has been growing for 15 years and is now a master grower. He creates something between a Japanese garden and Edward Scissorhands topiaries, with a vast canopy of buds and an immaculately clean undergrowth. During my visit, we see how he creates optimal growth, carefully filling every nook and cranny with super vibrant and healthy plants. We talk about growing techniques, garden setup, his strains this year from the Humboldt Seed Company and the Humboldt Seed Organization. Upon arrival at his farm, we find him keeping a close watch on buds that might rot during periods of fall moisture, which plague cannabis growers of the coastal plains of California. This is our first visit with Peter G during the harvest period, and you won't want to miss this if you ever plan to grow outdoors. This is an educational experience chock full of tips learned through hard work and toil over the years. Enjoy. So we're here with Petey, back here with Petey in the bloom time. How are you, Petey?
I'm pretty good. You?
I'm good, thanks.
I'm always good.
Excellent. That's what I say. Plants are looking rather healthy, bro.
Yeah, well, I've been doing this 10 plus years, so.
Mm-hmm. 15 is by my count.
Oh, snow drifts. I'm talking snow drifts.
There's the Girl Scout cookies right here?
Yep, on the corner. She is just ready, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Almost, the hairs are almost gone. It's a good strain, man. It's a hardy strain. It stands the elements well, I believe. How does it smell, though?
It smells kind of like mine, only a little bit more. Not the same, actually, but, you know, Girl Scout cookie is kind of hard to pin down.
Very similar to the pineapple upside down cake.
Pineapple upside down cake smells amazing. Now,
this is the purple punch wedding cake, which also really resembles the Girl Scout cookies, huh?
Uh-huh. So, looking at your plants, I notice you have the tape that keeps the insects from getting on your plant.
Inside out duct tape with tanglefoot, which is pine sap. Painted around it, nothing will crawl up, no ants. If you have ants, it's the only way to keep them away.
Mm-hmm. Look at this one over here. Quite a few of them, right?
Yeah.
And here are the plants that you actually trellised a little bit. What do they call it? You put it back and bent them over and put
just
them back in the
growing
dirt?
Growing it horizontal in the soil.
Oh my God.
As you can see, I cut this one down today and it actually puts in roots wherever the main stem was buried. See the roots coming out of the main stem? So you get a lateral.
Originally,
edge
the main stem was down
like
here.
An edge, huh?
Is this the first main stem?
Yeah, the main.
Main stem's down
root
here.
Is here. These are the first
branches. Yeah.
As it grows out, you keep staking it down.
Uh huh.
And it wants to grow up. See these wires? I put. I put staples in the side of this wood and kept on stringing wire across to hold it down. And it's kind of a hassle, but obviously.
It works,
it more
right?
Hardy, right?
Look at that. Look at how many main stems you got popping out of the ground right there.
Harder to protect.
And this is a blueberry muffin.
Every branch grows as its own plant, right?
Yeah.
Look at this.
He's so the buds are big everywhere.
Huh? This one, nice. It's not going south yet.
No. This is blueberry muffin here, this one here?
Yeah. She's really pretty, man. I want to cut her down before she starts rotting, because I live in a humid climate, so I got to cut it down early. There's another Girl Scout cookies.
Yeah, they're darker, like,
yeah. Yeah.
Let's go back there. Let's. We have these giant leaves underneath here. Somewhere.
Can you get a picture looking up into here?
Mm-hmm. Oh my God.
No, stand up. Or, yeah, under there is pretty cool. I don't see any rotten buds, please. Take a picture looking up.
Oh my God.
Look how fluffy and white that is. Oh, that's just God. Fucking maximum. Could it be any more maxed out? Tell me.
I don't know, bro.
No, it's optimum, as you would call it.
Shit.
That's optimum growth right there, buddy. Beautiful purple stems.
Look at the beautiful purple stems.
Lollipopped, of course. I did have a couple scales, but they were only on the lower part of the stems. You can see they always end up in there.
Yeah, yeah.
I rubbed those off.
Brought by the ants?
I think it's a white fly thing. Because the ants never got up on these. Look at this beautiful Girl Scout cookie. These snowdrifts. That's what it's all about. Fuck. See, when they're like this, they just look so beautiful. And then when they, as they mature, they just get haggard looking, it seems. I don't know. Doing something right. We're gonna take a picture of those two next to each other. The difference.
Newberry and the Girl Scout cookie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look how white that is.
Oh my goodness. Resin production's really up here. Go be sure.
I can cut it down.
What, this one?
No, that one.
The blueberry muffin?
I'm trying to get another week if I'm lucky, or two if I'm lucky. If I can go to the middle of the month, I'd be stoked. And look at this. This is three blue kings. It's a sativa, as you can tell. It's just massive. Constantly training it to grow underneath the net here, man. It was a battle. Look at...
Oh, those leaves look like they're related to tie leaves. They're so big and...
Has a three blue kings. It's I don't know. It's a massive king.
And I notice you have, like, triangled off some of the growing areas.
Yeah, just to takes less soil. And
mm-hmm.
I was thinking I was going to grow it horizontal. I didn't want to have to fill the whole thing in.
Right.
So I made it like this, and I thought I was going to... I started one here, but it got all fucked up, and I killed it and started over. Which okay, I'm so better off because it wouldn't have been...
We noticed the grow bag buried.
Yeah, the and grow bags. Just put them right in. I cut many slices in the bottom of those. But it doesn't matter. They grow right through them.
God, it smells so blueberry right here. This was... What is this?
Three Blue Kings.
So, Three Blue Kings is not blueberry, but smells blueberry-ish. Or maybe I was getting a drift.
It's like Headband, OG, I think. And no, it has blueberry in it. It's also...
Yeah, it smells blueberry.
What's that strain I'm trying to make? Fucking the blue, they call it blue.
Blue Dream.
Blue Dream, yeah. Blue Dream.
Blue Dream, I always thought was a
Headband,
Colombian
OG,
derivative.
This. Wow.
You remember the Gold Colombian, right, Petey?
Yeah.
So I always thought the Blue Dream was somehow descended from like a Gold Colombian. Does that make sense?
I wouldn't know.
Yeah. Well, I had some Blue Dream that really tasted like Gold Colombian.
A lot of freaking colas. There it is. Fuck, man. Couple more weeks.
What a canopy, Pete.
Yeah, look at that.
Shit, man.
Yeah.
so.
I haven't seen any rotting buds on this one yet.
No, they don't look too, so that, let's go to the one that had the, you cut off a bud earlier.
The KZOG, this one. It closed.
Oh yeah, this
really
is a weird
good.
Looking one. It's come right out here.
Okay, and I didn't have room for it, here. But I just butchered it and made it fit in.
Mm-hmm.
Well, look at that, it's half pound, right?
Wild.
She's beefy. See all the nodes, the, what do you call those things?
The brack nodes?
The bracts are all fat.
Yeah. And they don't even have seeds in them. That's wild.
He's got some nice ones too. That's a good sign when those are fat.
Uh-huh.
Very uplifting, soaring strain. It's the best of both worlds.
Three Blue Kings?
Yeah. Fucking zillion buds on this one. Jeez. They look like they'll be easy to trim though.
They do, right?
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, these are way.
Fuck, I don't even know what's going on. These KZs. KZOG.
Where does KZOG come from? It's that Humboldt seed organization?
I grew four strains from Humboldt seed organization, and I grew four strains from Humboldt seed company.
Three strains?
Four. I got the Purple Punch wedding cake, Girl Scout
cookies.
Oh, you got
that?
Yeah. The blueberry muffin.
Oh, the Purple Punch wedding cake is from Pacific. Oh, wait, no.
Oh, I got them from you.
Yeah, that's a different, that's not Humboldt Seed Company.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, it came from Pacific Genetics or something like that.
One seed you gave me like 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Those were great, yeah.
Looks like the Girl Scout cookies, very
yeah.
Similar. Took longer to start.
Oh my god.
This one's just fucking lost Tina. This one's looking unbelievable.
The red stems
Girl Scout cookies
and purple.
The
purplish red stems.
Unbelievable frost. Fuck, I gotta take it before it rots.
So, the bigger and fatter the cola, the more likely it will be to rot. Is that
yes.
Correct?
And some strains rot easier than others.
Mm-hmm.
Too. Like
right.
The fluffy, I don't know. Indicas rot too, they all. That one's fucking primus right now. It's fucking 5th week, 6th week, 6 week, 7th week, I don't know.
Of budding? Yeah.
Probably's. They've been all started relatively around April, May, June, July 15th. I started feeding them blooming nutrients, but they weren't all blooming.
Right.
Only that one had started, really.
Oh, yeah. It's always the dilemma,
they
right?
All, yeah. Look at the bracts on that. Look like they're fucking. Look at them. When you get that, you're doing something right, man. I used to never get those.
And they don't even have seeds.
Every one of these plants have fat bracts on them. I finally figured out the fucking mixture to use for the rest of my life.
No seed in there.
No.
But they're as fat as the ones that have seeds.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Isn't that strange? They're just big old female nodes waiting.
Yeah, those are the ones that usually get the seeds early. That's where I got most of my seeds from my cross. Here's a bee on your back, Petey, on your shirt. Here, let me just get them off. Go on.
Dummy, get out of here, dummy.
Oh, yeah.
This one.
How did he get in here?
That's some. These are some fucking fat indica buds, dude.
Is this the one we cut the top off? No.
No.
What is that, Petey? This is
pineapple upside down cake.
Oh my God, that's right.
It's the best strain from your buddy.
This.
Well, all his strains were great. All
is my favorite. Though. I must now come and smell it again.
It's dank. It wants two more weeks.
It probably
it's
does.
It's only going to get one. Like I said, I found a rotten bud on it today.
One this
tiny,
one?
Tiny little rotten
spot. Mm-hmm.
But you know, if there's one...
There's going to be more.
Pretty dense in there, too, man. I've pulled out all the leaves I could get to. See, some people say don't defoliate. Fuck, mm-hmm. I always defoliate. You know.
I read somewhere... when you know during budding you defoliate like 10% a week or something like that.
Right. Yeah. And this is that gnarly OG that just always look at that.
Freaking sky high, bro.
Fucking bracts on this one.
You kept this one kind of narrow and tall so it would fit the
place,
right?
I had no room for it. You can see I didn't. This one was here first.
Uh huh.
This one I just had to fit it in, man. It's gnarly. You can't even see what's going on, but it's fucking gnarly, dude.
And your screen, how much UV does it block? Not much, right?
It supposedly lets 85% through, so 15%.
Well, yeah. Well, that's an interesting screen.
This one's for sure. It wants a couple more weeks. She was slow, but it's amazing. Once they go, they really go. She's stout. She's just like a blueberry muffin.
I notice you have...
This is in case it rains.
Really?
I have it on pulleys that pull up. I have 10 feet.
Go the plastic on the side?
10 feet wide, and it goes the full length of the thing, which is 26 feet. I got pulleys. Just in case it rains, I can sit in here, and it cranks it up. I'll be able to vent it in the middle.
Uh-huh.
See where the pulley is.
Yeah.
One comes on one side, one comes there. So my vent would be right there. Better than getting the whole thing ruined.
Yeah, and
I've
you
had to pull the plastic up in the rain before.
Mm-hmm.
And I just keep it at the ready, as you can see. When it's raining, your bucket was squalling one time. I'm trying to pull this big plastic over the whole thing. It was like a sail.
Battle.
Thing ripped out of my hands. I hit myself in the forehead. I'm bleeding and it's raining. I'm yelling at my 80-year-old neighbor, help me, help me. I had just about given up and I gave it one last try and pulled it over. It's all stretched out with these giant fans. See these giant fans? You get those from Harbor Freight?
Uh-huh.
Those are the best, man. It's like a wind machine.
Dry them out real quick?
In the morning. I have one there and I have one way over there.
Yeah. Well... I don't have to deal with that, but...
And I still get rotten buds.
No.
That one had a fan directly on it, and it was just going, I'm done.
Look how big those leaves are over there, Petey.
Well, these are the small ones. When the ones down here, I had one leaf over there. It was 16 inches wide.
Wow.
Right?
Yeah.
Had 13 fingers on it.
Remember last year? You had, like, another...
Same.
Instead of giant leaves.
Huge leaves on them, like that wide, foot wide or more. Oh man, this strain's a great strain, right? Every one of them is just fucking.
This is what, KZOG?
Yeah.
And this comes from this Humboldt Seed organization.
There's THC to the tips of every leaf.
Which is not to be confused with Humboldt Seed Company.
Right.
Interesting. And I notice you have
look at it.
Your mirror reflecting. Around.
It's a water heater insulation.
Is that what that is?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been using Mylar. Mylar is really reflective, man.
But I couldn't find any of that. Plus, the stuff you have is smooth and it creates hot spots. Whereas
it sure does, bro.
Yes. I used to use it here and it would burn certain
plants. Yeah, you'd focus like some magnifying glass.
It's really forgiving.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to have to. I have to check when I get
home.
It costs
like $40 for a 26 feet or 4 feet wide.
Oh wow.
What a difference it makes. I mean, look at.
Yeah.
late in the day. It's just, yeah, it's just.
So we see all the wires you had to cut to get this plant out.
Yep.
Your trellising is just amazing, Petey.
100-foot, 100-pound test fishing line, and then I got your this is the best shit in the world. This clothesline.
Uh-huh.
It's got wire in it.
Uh-huh.
And then I put all these posts in it, so everything's stable. Everything's placed and tied up. See, every one of them are positioned to not lay on each other.
Yeah, it's incredibly organized. Compared
to the Girl Scout and this purple punch, the branches all pretty much stay separated.
Uh-huh.
It grows really stout. Very similar. Nice little fucking stalk, like my wrist.
Shit, bro, that's pretty fat.
Yeah, not bad. And once again, you can see I just plopped my little three-gallon pot right in there and filled in around it. And all these things are covered with this, see this wire mesh?
Mm-hmm.
In case gophers, it's completely lined so the gophers can't get in.
It's hard
cats
to
killed a gopher like 2 days ago. I'm like, yes. I didn't even know there were any left.
The cats?
Yeah, they do really good with the gophers. This one, I gotta do some exploratory and see if it's rotting. Look at these massive buds. That's a sugar breath.
Uh-huh. That's the one we could cut the top off earlier. Because it did have a bit of mold.
Doesn't get enough sun over here, you can see, man. This thing just wanted to overtake it. And these were started, see, this strain it grows so fast, I started like a month after. All my KZs I started a month after all these.
Oh my god.
Yeah, that one over there, it grew so fucking fast. I call it the monster. That's the true monster. Nice and wet.
So?
I water every four to five days.
Mm-hmm. Because they retain the moisture.
Before I defoliated, I had to water some of them every 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
But then I backfilled soil around them, and that insulates them and it holds moisture longer.
Mm-hmm.
Before, these were just sitting on top and I had to water them every 2 to 3 days.
And when you water them, Petey, do you pour the water in the pot area?
In the pot and around it.
And around it. Mm-hmm. And may we ask what you've been feeding your plants, Petey? I know they're most growers.
Full line
don't
of
like
advanced
it.
Nutrients.
Mm-hmm.
And I also, on my watering days, I feed it with powder, Aurora.
Mm-hmm.
The Aurora dry powder feeding schedule. So I'm feeding them every time they get watered.
Wow.
Nutrient powder. And that's why they're like this. I've never had them like this before. With all these fat bracts, the powder made the difference.
Uh-huh.
It really did. It's nasty.
So it gives you more control over the micronutrients?
In two pots. I had it in this 3 gallon. I put it in this 15 gallon and dropped it in. It still grows through.
Mm-hmm.
That way you can keep them off to the side and go, well, you're going here and you're going there. Because if I put one in the wrong place, like this one, it's,
right,
it wants to block everybody out. But I kept it subdued. It's a great strain. Look at it. I think it's better. I don't know.
You come over here. Let me switch places. Here, you come over here.
Frosty as fuck.
Oh my god, look at this blueberry muffin right here.
Oh, that's
the Girl Scout cookie, excuse me. This is the blueberry muffin.
No, that's the purple punch wedding cake.
Oh, the one I gave you. Oh my god, bro.
Very similar to the Girl Scout cookie.
Uh-huh.
Leaves are starting to turn purple on it. She was slow. That plant. She's ready. See how weathered looks weathered on the front? Looks like there's amber
over
on
there?
The leaves on this.
Yeah, yeah.
But
Should you get out your microscope and look at the trichomes?
No, I'm just gonna cut her down.
Uh huh.
In a day or so.
Yeah.
On the back, it's still fluffy white.
Uh huh.
It just it melts like those leaves are just like taffy.
It grows a gnarly plant.
There's some nice colas.
Mm-hmm.
That's a two. Looks like 2 pounds to me. Those buds are dank.
Yeah.
They're very, not like the fluffy blueberry muffin.
Mm-hmm. Fluff. Whoa.
God, you can smell it. It smells like toxic sewer.
Toxic sewer? Wait a minute.
Like sewage,
we can come up with a better.
This one's just pure astringent. Just fucking Lysol.
Shit. What is it? It kind of like, it smells like a, can't really pin it down, something
cheesy, right?
Well, or something baked, or something cinnamony, or something, I don't know, it has a range of different.
Quite the terpene profile.
Yeah. I took the words right out of my lagging brain.
Man.
Yeah.
Very few hairs.
Yeah, this one's gonna be gnarly. Oh. This is the Pacific genetics or something like that.
I think the brown spots are just a deficiency as I'm flushing them.
Brown spots? You mean, I think that's something coming from above and dripping down on it. No?
It's a deficiency, I think.
Uh-huh. Shall we go on the side?
If you want. Oh, this one's gotta be rotting, I know it is. Still budding its ass off. These buds will get massive. Too bad I'm in the wrong climate.
Uh-huh.
Fuck. It's irritating. I tell you what, it'll be killer smoke.
Oh, sure it will.
We'll cut them down early. Almost everywhere. Fluffy white still. Delicious. Oh, got my fingers crossed.
We got them crossed for you, too.
Gnarly, huh?
Mm-hmm. Very impressive.
I used to have losers. Loser after loser, now I have winner after winner. How's that? Just keep the fucking cats and moths out.
Cats like to come in here?
They do, but if there's a wild cat that lives in our barn and he got caught inside here, and ever since then he hasn't been coming out here. He used to shit on my fucking nets.
Oh wow.
He'd like to shit right in between these. I set up mouse traps back in there and but then I'd walk around going tick tick tick, like 8 of them, like, and he got caught in here.
Feet down?
Yeah, it's 4 feet wide. See the cage over there? It's 4 feet wide.
Oh, I see.
So it goes four.
Oh my
feet
God!
Down.
So the gophers can't come out.
Yeah.
And then wow.
Yeah. So it's like growing in like 200 gallons of soil.
Uh huh.
You got your 20-pound pot going into 100 or who knows, 100 gallons maybe.
Uh huh.
So that just has room to grow. This is one very top and tied up.
What is this one, Petey?
This is the KZ.
KZOG.
Seems to have more of a sativa influence than the others, right?
Uh-huh. Where is the Three Blue Kings one?
That's this purple girl. She's slow.
And, oh, wait, the pineapple, you have another pineapple,
pineapple.
Out here? Oh. Pineapple skunk. The pineapple skunk has a fragrance that reminds me.
It's a fruity.
It almost reminds me of Big Sur Hollyweed.
Mixed with Mexican.
Right. Which is
Mexican mixed with Afghani. That's classic every seed company has their take on this.
Yeah. Oh, amazing.
Look how dainty that one, I just butchered it.
Fully dank, bro. What's that? If you had the right climate, what?
Yeah, these would be 4 foot long colas. And I gotta keep everything really fucking sano.
Yeah, well, you don't want 4 foot long colas here.
This one resembles the pineapple skunk for some reason. I've gotta be able to see through the plant. See everything nice mm-hmm. and separated.
Oh, wow. So clean and
yes. Everything's just under the net. You see all the extra extensions I had to put on? See all these extensions?
Uh-huh.
Because I start growing this way and then
yeah, I saw that.
I'm like out here with the you get nothing you can't do with a hose clamp and a piece of electrical conduit. And these are old tent poles. I'd put one up and it would grow to the edge of that, and then I'd have to put another one up, uh-huh. you know. Because you don't want to come out here and see your leaves going against the net. It
just I know.
Makes them
I've had to pull
like
back
that.
Some of my branches.
Plus, I think the insects can get to them and lay the egg through the net.
I know.
All over the plants.
Petey's taking a bud out here that he suspects has mildew. What do you call it, bud rot, basically?
Yes. Nasty fucking vermin.
Nice looking bud though. Where is the rot?
It's right in there.
Right. Where that wrinkled leaf is? The one that has all the...
See yeah. the brown?
Yeah.
I want to get this out of here. Okay. It's a vector. Now we get to find out how much it's rotten. You just sort of go, ooh, look at all the ladybugs.
Oh my God.
I wonder if they made it rot.
Shitting in there and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, well they do that. All
right. You like that?
How many are there? Man, there's like 10 of them in there,
three,
right?
Three, I don't know. I want to go flick them off outside. There's a sick.
Yeah, the top is okay, right? Looks like it.
Yep, top is okay.
Well, you get your top 2 inches of the
bud. Makes me want to barf. These are some fucking fat indica buds, too.
Is this the one we cut the top off? No.
No.
What is that, Petey? This is a...
Pineapple upside down cake.
Oh my God, that's right.
It's the best strain from your buddy.
This...
Well, all his
the
strains were
this
great.
Has,
all
is my his favorite, though. I must now come and smell it again.
It's dank. It wants 2 more weeks.
It probably
it's
does.
It's only gonna get one.
And saltwater pools. nothing goes wrong, and everybody would sing this song, and the band gets paid. Now we're living in a perfect world, and every boy's gonna get his girl.
Sing, 'cause what we do is dream.